Hello friends, I welcome in the Aanav Creation. I am your teacher for Digital Marketing Season 2. Today we are going to start cross borders with SEO. Don't forget to subscribe the channel and hit the like button of that video. Let's get started. Hello friends and welcome back. As you know, our topic is cross borders with the SEO in the Digital Marketing Season 2. So in this lesson, we will explain how search engine optimization SEO strategy can help your business reach international prospects and customers. If your potential customers are in different countries or speak multiple languages, there are many aspects to consider. We will go over the most important ones: language, localization, and country retargeting. First thing first, you will need to speak your customer's language literally for every topic. There are some SEO guidelines for websites that offer content in multiple languages. The first is to make sure that each page in a different language has its own unique web page. So why is that so important? Let's say you grow avocados in the UK and you want to sell your prime product to other countries as well. Web design technology makes it possible to have English language content on a web page, say www.example.com/avocado.html, but allow visitor to click a button to view the same page written in the French. Sounds good, right? The problem is that humans can click that button, but search engines can't. The better approach is to separate each translated version onto its own web page. In this example, it would be much better to place the French version in its own page with a separate URL like www.example.com/avocat.html. The second thing to keep in mind, mixing languages on the same pages. This is a big no-no. For example, when half of your content is in French and other half is in English, search engines can't decide what language your content is in. It's better to use different pages for different languages. Next, avoid using automated service to translate your content. Have a piece of content about organic produce that needs to be in French. Get a real life person to translate it for you. Why is this necessary? Well, search engines don't value content generated from automated translation tools. Even worse, the page might be considered spam. Translation services may cost a little bit more upfront, but you are likely to have a higher quality content that can drive better results for your business. If you have taken the time to translate content, some search engines allow you to add language annotations to your web pages easily. So these annotations help search engines serve the right content to the right person based on his or her country or language. Let's imagine you are a farmer who ships delicious fruits and vegetables across borders. You have created some great content for your UK clientele, but you have also had the same content carefully translated into German for your market in Germany. One such page is all about avocados is present in the website. As a farmer, you did expect from German avocado page to show up on a search results page for your prospects in Germany and your UK page for your customers in the UK. To help search engines discover this alternate content, in this case, you did able to add an annotation to each English and German page. These tags will mark your pages so search engines can serve up the right version of your content to viewers in their respective countries as well. When you explore annotations a bit further, you will see that they can be a great tool for more advanced multilingual and multinational setups. This covers some of the structural considerations for adding different languages to your website. But even if you don't add multiple languages, there are other considerations for customers in different countries and markets. Start by thinking about what information would be useful for them and what are not. Do you need to provide products prices in different currencies? Do they use a different system of measurements, metric versus imperial? For example, would customers weigh your avocados in kilos or pounds? Did you include local addresses and phone numbers so they can contact you? Do you need to list your business hours in different time zones? These are all small things you can do to make sure your website remains useful to potential customers in different countries as well. There are also signals to help search engines understand your content is relevant to international markets. Beyond language and localization, you can help search engines understand the country or countries you are targeting. For instance, if your website has a country code, top level domain CCTLD for short, it's a strong indication that your site targets a specific country. An example of an UK site with CCTLD would be www.avocadofarm.co.uk as an example. For Germany, that site might be www.avocadofarm.de. And if it does not, what if you have a generic domain such as www.example.com? Search engines may use a number of factors including where your website is hosted, the IP address and the information on the web pages. You can still help your site and its content be more visible to international prospects by using country targeting tools, such as those found in Google Search Console, and there you have it. As you start promoting your website in other countries as well, keep three things in mind: language, localization, and country targeting. If you do, you can adjust your website and SEO strategy to make your website an international success. Want to learn more? So stay tuned. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit the like button. I hope you liked this video. Thank you very much. Have a good day.